Hello everyone. Good morning everyone. Hope you all are doing well. And in this lecture, I'm concluding the previous, that is fourth unit only. In last lecture, if we are briefing about that, we have completed speech of motivations, exam, or speaking skills and everything. Today, I'll take the topic that is called body language. In communication, body languages also play a very important and vital role in terms of the communications. When we are speaking, for example, different peoples have the different body languages. Might be they having some of a habit of just shaking his legs or hands, or most of the peoples have, when they are talking, they don't have put the eye contact with the audience or with the peoples who are just facing to them. And if we're talking about the body language, it is a kind of non-verbal communication where thoughts, intentions, and feelings are expressed by physical behavior, such as facial expressions. If you're having, if for example, let's take example of if a person, one of the person is just giving you a, just moving his hand from here and there, then you can come to know he might be he's calling you. Or else if a person having a smile and saying a good morning to you, or just having a smile in the response of your good morning, that means yes, everything is fine and he's take your greetings basically. Then such as facial expressions, body postures, gestures, eye movement. Let's take another example of the eye movement. When you are talking with the small kids and you want to make them fear from you, and you just put your eyes on the as much you can open that and make the small kids that they are just getting a fear from you, or sweet smile to motivate or to give a smile on the baby's face. This is basically the gesture and posture of the body language, and this plays a very important role while we are communication. And basically, as you all know, this is a speech wordless language, in which you are just moving your hands from here and there, blinking your eyes, nodding your heads, is just communicate your message to from sender to the receiver of the message. Body language exists both animals and humans, but this article focuses on interpretations of human body language. It is also known as kinesics. Let's move to the next slide, that is called the importance elements of body language. Of course, we come to know that first elements, we can say that body postures, the way you are sitting, the way you are standing, the way you are lie down, the way you are walking, these are the body postures. And we have a different ways to use our bodies postures. Like when we have to sit to the stand, so most of the people are standing very straight, but most of the standing just like to lose their body and just standing, and they don't know how to stand over there. Most of the people are sitting very straightly, that their shoulders also very straightforward, and sometimes just they have to sit in, they just put it there like this side, hand this side. And this is basically a body posture, and which and on this the research has shown that body posture is more accurately recognized when an emotions is compared with a different or neutral emotions. It also speaks your language, your message, through your body postures. Next, we can say personal appearance. Appearance can alter physiological reactions, judgments, and interpretation, as it is right said that first impression is the last impression. Yes, most of the people are believing this quotation also, that first impression is the last impression. Because when we meet somebody, how they treat to us, or else how they do greet to us, this is a main matter. If we are just just meet one, and after that meeting someone first time, then we have the some imagination or some experiences. Yes, he or she is very nice, or he or she very very, we can say, authentic or very smart. This is basically how we react towards the people. They just make the judge on behalf of our behavior. That is called basically personal appearance. And individuals have their different types of personal appearance in front of the people. Next, come to the point that is called facial expression. Facial expression is integral when expressing emotions through the body. Combination of eyes, Eyebrows, lips, nose, cheek movements hail from different modes of individuals. Example, happy, sad, depressed, angry. Yes, if you're talking about the facial expressions, your facial expression shows that what are running inside in your mind, or what type of feeling your what type of we can say thought process is running in your mind, that comes automatically on your facial expressions. If you are happy, then automatically you have a sweet or a very huge smile on your face. If you are in tension, that expression also expressed on your face, that can be concluded by other people, and they can ask what's the problem, your face is saying something. And if you want to hide that, also that you cannot hide that such problems. This is the role of the facial expression. Now that is called gestures. What is gestures? Basically, gestures are movement made with the body parts like hands, arm, fingers, heads, leg, and they may be voluntary or involuntary. Arm gestures can be interpreted in several ways. As you can see in the slide, the image of the gestures. In a discussion, when one stands or sit with folded arm, this is normally not a welcoming gestures. You put your hands, you cross your fingers, stand up your thumbs. That is basically come under the your gestures, how you communicate your message. If you are, for example, if you're taking terms of the gestures, where if you seeing something very interesting, or if you're seeing someone is just a winner prize or winning a prize, then you just put your thumbs up and just to make them a cheer up. This is the main point. Next point is that is called eye contact. Eye contact, it serves three main purposes. First, to give and receive feedback. Second, to show confidence and honesty. And third, to communicate relation between peoples. Until or unless you don't face the audience, you don't have the eye contact with the audience, you are just lacking in your confidence. It is a main point to be a confident in front of the people, in front of the audience, just to have a eye contact with them. Until unless you don't have, you are just having a fearing, you are just having a lack of confidence, might be having a several thinking thought processes going running in your mouth, what's going to be done, what's going to be happen. This is a main problem. So just to be of up from this problem, you can say that be having an eye contact and speak. Yes, it speaks more than your words. If you are seeing somebody and saying something, might be he can come conclude the things more effectively rather than on your words. Next, we can say other types of physical movement. In this, we can say like covering one's mouth suggests suppressions of feeling and perhaps certainty. This include also mean he or she thinking hard and maybe ensured of what to say next. Next, we come to next slide where next topic is called the paralanguage. What is paralanguage? Paralanguage basically means it's focused on rather than what you say, it's focused on how you say. It's not focused on the way you are, what you are saying, but yes, it is focusing on that how you are saying or how you communicate. Okay, now in this we have say in slide also you are saying a different type of emojis nowadays you are using and communicating a wordless chat on your WhatsApp or in your mails, and you are just using the different types of emojis which express your feelings or which express your words of mouth to the peoples. Let's come to the explanations. Paralanguage, also known as vocalics, is a component of metacommunication that may modify meaning, give nuanced meaning, or convey emotions. By using technique such as prosody, pitch, volume, intonation, etc. It is sometimes defined as relating to non-phonemic properties only. Paralanguage may express consciously or unconsciously. The study of paralanguage is known as paralinguistics and was invented by George L. Traeger in 1950s. While he was working at the Foreign Service Institute of the Department of State, his colleagues at the time included Henry Leigh Smith, Charles F. Hockett, working with him on using descriptive linguistics as a model of paralanguage. Edward T. Hall developing proxemics and Ray Bird whistles, developing kinesis, struggle, published in conclusion in 1958, 1969. This slide shows the intro how para languages come into the existing points. The paralinguistic properties of speech play an important role in human communication. There are no utterances or speech signals that lack paralinguistic properties, since speech requires the presence of voice that can be modulated. Let's come to the next. What are the aspects of the speech signal? That is basically prospective aspects, organic aspects, expressive aspects, linguistic aspects. I'll take this topic or this might be this concept in the next lecture. Hopefully you will go through this particular lectures, and if you have any queries, then free to ask me anytime. Be safe and stay home. Thank you.